In this video, I want to show you how to calculate R squared. Now here I have an example with three variables. If I'm trying to find R squared for just two variables, one way we can go about doing that is just running a correlation. Let me show you what I mean here. So if I go to Analyze and then Correlate and then Bivariate, let's say we want R squared between SAT and college GPA. So I'll move those two over and then I'll click OK. Now this gives me not R squared, but it gives me R. So the correlation between SAT and college GPA is 0.65. And that is in fact significant at the 0.01 level. Now that's R. So if I want R squared, what I can do is just simply square that. So 0.65 and squared here is 0.4225. So R squared here is 0.42. Now, another way to do this is that if I have more than two variables that I'm working with, or if I just don't feel like calculating R squared manually by squaring R, what I can do is I can go to Analyze and then Regression and select Linear. Now, I have to decide here what my dependent variable is, or what it is that I'm trying to predict. Now, SAT was measured in high school, and college GPA is the variable sounds. Is GPA in college during the first year after 1 year of college. So it makes sense that SAT would predict college GPA. So we'll put the thing we're trying to predict in the dependent box, and then we'll put SAT in the independent. Okay, let's go ahead and click OK. Now if you recall from our earlier analysis, when we squared that correlation, we got 0.4225. So R squared was 0.4225. And here, to find R squared, we want to go to the model summary table, and then we want to look, here's R, this is the correlation, 0.65, we saw that in our previous analysis, and then R squared is right next to R, notice 0.422, and that's exactly what we got before within rounding error. So we can run regression to calculate R squared. Now, in case you're not familiar with what R squared is, it indicates the amount of variance in the dependent variable that is accounted for or explained by the independent variable. So since we were using SAT here to predict college GPA, what that means is if we know a person's SAT score, we can account for, I can convert this to a percentage, about 42% of the variance in college GPA, which is pretty good. Okay, so that's what R squared means. It's a measure of how much we explained in one variable using one or more other variables. And one last thing here, if you want to calculate R squared and you have more than two variables at once, then you really need to use this regression approach here to find that. So let's say we want to use both SAT and social support to predict college GPA, and we're doing this to try and get our R squared, to see how well overall these two predictors combined, how much of college GPA they account for or explain, which you may recall is what R squared really means. How much of the variance did we account for in a given variable using one or more other variables? So go ahead and click OK. And then here, notice our R squared increased, and it will when we add another predictor in almost all cases. And here our R squared is 0.511. So using social support and SAT, we can account for about 51% of the variance in college GPA. So the GPA in college after their first year. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching.